Hello everyone, Kenneth Steines here from Sensei. In recent years, Microsoft's focus has been on building a very capable yet flexible platform for PPM, where the emphasis is on using Microsoft Project to manage the work, Microsoft Teams for collaboration, and the Power Platform for PPM and reporting. This platform really supports a broad range of disciplines, from tasks to project management, program and portfolio management, resource management, strategy, and more. And we're not limited to one task management tool either. The platform allows teams to work the way they want and manage the tasks and tools that make sense to them, like Project Online, Project for the Web, Planner, Azure DevOps, and Jira. The key is that regardless of where the tasks are being managed, the project managers and their teams get a consistent approach to project management across these. That means collaboration, document management, issues, risks, change requests, financials, and reporting is all consistent, as is intake, program management, and portfolio management. Resource managers can manage their people more efficiently also, with standardized resource requests, allocations to projects, and a consolidated timesheet that pulls together all work across tools. From a strategy perspective, executives can define the strategic themes and goals for the organization and connect benefits tracking to projects, programs, and portfolios. So we're truly connecting strategy to execution on this platform. Let's take a look at how the pieces come together. We'll start with Microsoft Project for the Web to manage the work. Project for the Web is a relatively new offering from Microsoft and is based on the scheduling engine from the desktop client and Project Online that project managers have been using for many years. There are three different task-focused views: the grid view, board view, and timeline. Here we have all the tasks laid out in a grid view. There's the task name, who it's assigned to, percent complete, start, finish, duration, effort remaining, dependencies, and labels. And those are just the ones we're currently showing. There are more over here. If I open up a single task, we can explore more of the functionality. This task is to test the module integration, and I can see that it's part of system testing. We can see who's assigned to the task, and below that, any labels we may have added. There's a description to ensure we have a shared understanding of the work. Then start, finish, duration, percent complete, as you would expect. We can organize the work into buckets, and you get to choose the names of these buckets just like the labels. We can add detailed checklist items to help track progress at a more granular level inside of the task. Then there's completed effort, remaining effort, and total effort. If you add any local custom fields to your project, these will also show up here. On the right, we have the dependencies and attachments. These attachments can reference the team files in your SharePoint document library, as you would expect. It's a very solid task experience today, and Microsoft keeps adding more functionality all the time. All views come with the ability to filter the tasks. We can filter for finish date, for example, for tasks that are running late, progress to see tasks that are not started, in progress, or completed, labels to see all the tasks with a certain label applied, buckets to filter tasks by department in this case, priority for low, medium, important, and urgent tasks. Critical path. And in the timeline view, these tasks will also be highlighted in red, as you may be used to from the Project Desktop client. Assigned to, which is a great way to see what each team member is working on. Even some custom fields show up in the filter, as we see with the value field here. In the board view, we get a Kanban-like experience. The buckets here are defined for each project, so you can make them whatever you want. You can color code each bucket and drag and drop tasks between them. And in addition to buckets, we can view the tasks by assigned to, progress, finish date, labels, and priority. The timeline is great for a more visual view of the project. When we mouse over a task, it highlights the dates at the top. And marking a task complete gives us that very satisfying ding. We can zoom the timeline and interact with the task bars, like extending them to increase the duration of a task, move a task by dragging it, or create dependencies between tasks. The schedule can be exported to Excel. The timeline can be exported to a PDF file. You can copy a project and use it as a starting point for your next one. And you can access the team files on the SharePoint site. The charts view is essentially a report that shows tasks by status, bucket, and effort per person. The people view is my new favorite. Here I can see how much work each team member has, either in hours or by count of tasks. It's easy to reassign work by dragging a task over to someone else. And I find the filter particularly useful here. For example, I may want to see all the tasks with a priority of urgent and important, or all the tasks with a label of testing. I think Microsoft Project for the Web delivers a very intuitive, easy-to-use task management experience. If you're used to using Microsoft Project Desktop and want to give Project for the Web a try, you can easily upload your MPP file and immediately see what it looks like here. One very clever and important technical detail is that Project for the Web uses the Microsoft 365 groups to provide access to the team and put all the infrastructure in place, including a SharePoint document library, OneNote, a shared mailbox and calendar, basically allowing the members of the group to collaborate and share information, which we'll see next inside of Microsoft Teams. When Project for the Web is used inside of Microsoft Teams, we get all the same great functionality we just saw, but now with a dedicated channel for team collaboration. That means we get the conversations and activity feed for the project, along with the files, which sit in SharePoint on the back end, of course, with version control and all the usual SharePoint features. OneNote for capturing meeting minutes, vendor conversations, and so on. We also have easy access to the Power BI status report for the project. All of this in addition to the tasks from Project for the Web. Another benefit of working inside of Microsoft Teams is that you can organize projects into programs and portfolios for easy navigation and collaboration. Everything we've looked at so far is standard functionality from Microsoft Project for the Web and then organized inside of Microsoft Teams. This combination really enables collaboration around the tasks of a project. It's very powerful, and you can do this today in your Office 365 tenant. Of course, most organizations want to do more than just manage the tasks and collaborate as a team, and that's where the Power Platform completes the picture and provides the additional advanced PPM capabilities and reporting. Since Project for the Web is natively integrated into Office 365 and the Power Platform, there are some very good options to add more advanced PPM capabilities around the projects. At Sensei, we've worked with hundreds of organizations, both commercial and government, to implement PPM. In the process, we have developed a turnkey Power Platform solution called Sensei IQ. Essentially, it's a template that helps our clients get started in a matter of a few days. Organizations can certainly take on building much of this functionality themselves in-house, but that can take many months or even years. Sensei IQ is a proven, connected, managed solution and a Microsoft preferred solution, which means it's maintained and updated by Sensei. One great example is a governance process for projects which is supported by the Dynamics Business Process Flow, where we can define the stages a project goes through and the checklist items that must be completed before proceeding. And you can add formal approvals and notifications with Power Automate. Key dates is used to track important milestones on the project that we want to report on to executives. The issues log and the risks register are other examples of PPM features that are commonly used. And with the tight integration to Azure Active Directory for the users, it's easy to add notifications and communicate in real time. Most of our clients also track their weekly project status through Power Apps, which then allows them to see the progression of the project and take a snapshot of key metrics each week. Managing the intake of work into the organization is another common usage scenario for the Power Platform. This enables an organization to see all the proposed initiatives and evaluate the business case and also assess the impact on staffing. While the work can be managed in different execution tools, resource management is best done in a layer above that, which means we can see the formal requests and allocation to projects, as well as the availability of our resources in real time. In the example here, Albert is allocated to customer support, internal IT production support, in addition to 3 projects. And it looks like he's overallocated by 44 hours this month. And since Power Apps can read data from multiple task management systems, our team members get a consolidated timesheet that shows all the work they're assigned to, in addition to non-project time and non-working time. We saw earlier how projects can be organized into programs and portfolios with teams and channels. This allows for a more focused view into a portion of the organization and helps to streamline reporting. Mature organizations can connect strategy to execution by defining their strategic themes and then track strategic goals and benefits on the projects, programs, and portfolios that deliver these. At Sensei, we're really excited about Microsoft's focus on a platform for PPM. It just provides a great deal of flexibility in terms of where teams do their work and still enables that consistent experience for collaboration and reporting to executives. If you enjoyed this video, please do subscribe to our channel for more PPM content. You will also find links to some great resources in the description of this video. And if you would like to learn more and engage with us to deploy the platform for PPM into your organization, please reach out to us. We can take you through a formal needs assessment and PPM roadmap review. Thanks for watching.